So welcome to the autoX show, Santosh. It's a pleasure having you here. So first of all, a big congrats because you have got a new sponsor in the shape of Farlupe. It's again, you're a factory rider, but again, more support is always good, right? What do you think about that?
I mean, like you mentioned, they're my new partner sponsors that I come on board this year. And it's exciting because I want to be a person that aligns myself to work with good brands that have a vision that's similar to what I have and what we want to achieve at the Dakar. So whether it's Hero, Red Bull or Sidwin, you know, and now with Fabi Lugo, I think we all share a similar DNA of being able to push boundaries and push the envelope. So I think for me, I'm excited with my journey with this brand.
Do you think motorsport is gaining popularity in the mainstream as well? Recently, Gaurav Gill was awarded the Arjuna Award. So I think motorsport is now slowly but steadily getting its due?
Well, you would imagine so, because you know it's really cool to see extraordinary individuals get recognized for their achievements on the international circuit. And I'm glad that that appreciation is coming now formally from the government. You know, we all knew that what he'd done. So it's cool that the government recognizes that. I also think that it's something that's really hard to ignore. You look at the industry, the size of the motorcycles that they sell in India, it's one of the biggest industry in the world. So obviously, if there's a sport that revolves around an industry, it makes sense for the government to recognize it. And I think this goes one step in a direction to which we want to be able to touch many customers or many people with the idea of motorsports and inculcate that love for it.
So coming back to you, recently you went to Baja Aragon and you secured a 10th place finish. So how was it? I mean, how was the recovery from the Dakar 2018?
So yes, I didn't have the best Dakar outing this year. I showed a lot of promise in the beginning and I've shown promise throughout the year with some speed. And yes, coming back from an injury is not the easiest part and it takes a bit of time. So I took my time with the Desert Storm and then finally I was able to go and race the Baja in Spain. I had a better result than the year before. I think the whole outlook is to be able to be better than what you were the year before and improve on your performance. So I think I did that. And if you can do that, the positions will obviously show. So I finished the top 10 in the Baja Aragon, so I'm happy with that. And now we have 4 months left to go to the Dakar. You know, it's like the year goes by so quickly and it's just 4 months left for the Dakar. So we have a lot of races and testing lined up and I'm excited to see how I can put this year together.
So what's in store for you before Dakar 2020?
As of now, when we finish this interview, you know, straight away I have only 2 weeks left here in India. So I will train here for 2 weeks. And then I will get shipped off to go to Spain. And then from Spain, I will go to Morocco where I spend 3 weeks. And these 3 weeks are between September and October. So September and October is going to be packed with races in Morocco. It's also a time where we bring out the new bike in Morocco. So we race the new bike in Morocco and the whole team will race together. So all four riders will be at the Morocco race. And pretty much everybody around the world that's competing in the Dakar is going to show up at Morocco. So I think it's a good testing ground for us as the final race of the year. And apart from these two races, we have another test lined up in Morocco again in November. So I think September, October, November, and pretty soon it's going to be Dakar. So full calendar.
So Dakar is going to Saudi Arabia next year and it's a hot topic, you know, among all the sponsors, even all the races. So what do you have to say about it?
For me, I liked South America a lot. You know, I've kind of grown to know and understand a little bit of what the Dakar entails when we go to South America. It's all I've known. The last 5 years of racing has been in South America. So I'm sad to leave South America, but I think it's a new challenge for us to go to Saudi Arabia and the slate is pretty much blank. It's a clean slate. I don't think any of us have an advantage in Saudi Arabia. I think for the first time, we're all going to experience a new country, a new challenge, a new perspective on the Dakar now that it's left South America. So I think it's a good thing because I think all of us start on a level playing field in terms of experience in Saudi Arabia. And I also am excited about the fact that, you know, in South America, the problem was the time zones. So usually when the telecast or the news would come back to India, it was always the next day. But in Saudi Arabia, I think we'll be on the same day, on the same time. So everybody will feel more involved in the process of following the Dakar. So I think this is one good thing that I'm going to take away from Saudi Arabia.
And do you think the terrain would be more or less similar to Peru, like last year in Dakar?
Well, I don't think it's going to be like Peru. I think Saudi Arabia, from what I've heard, has pretty much a little bit of everything, you know, from a desert point of view. So Peru was didn't have a lot of varying terrains, but I think Saudi Arabia will have more like mountains, it'll have tracks, it'll have rocks, it'll have fast tracks, it will also have a lot of dunes, it'll have camel grass. So pretty much anything and everything you think about in the desert, I'm sure we will have it. And yeah, it's going to be a tough Dakar. Like every year they have a new challenge and it's going to be no different.
So now talking about your playground, that is this place, Big Rock Dirt Park. So how do you train yourself around here? And I see a lot of, you know, even youngsters coming here and taking trainings and all that with you guys. So what's the whole concept? I mean, just give us a brief.
So Big Rock Dirt Park was put together 5 years ago. And the whole idea was for me to be able to enable people to ride their motorcycles regardless of terrain. Because in India, you can't expect just one surface of riding. So invariably, pretty much everybody that tours in India is an adventure rider. So we want to be able to help all of these people to understand their motorcycles a little better and understand what they could achieve with that motorcycles and places that they could access with their motorcycles. So we want to enable that process. So yes, at Big Rock, we basically run a lot of courses to help people with these basics.
And speaking of adventure, you have the X-Pulse 200 here. What do you have to say about this bike? Because Hero tells us that your inputs were in place for this bike. So what do you have to say? Is this a good base to start with?
I actually like this bike, you know, because when I think about the time when I started racing, I raced on a Suzuki Shaolin. That bike was a street bike, had no business going off-road. So if I was able to take that bike and learn all the off-road skills that I then grew into what I am today, I think this is a great bike to start off with, you know. I think in terms of a motorcycle that goes off-road, one of the biggest priorities is you need a bike that handles well and can take the punishment of where you want to go and what you can put it through. So in that aspect, I think it's a great motorcycle to begin with, not just the price point, but what it can achieve off-road. And I'm excited about this product because in a way, at Hero, we're able to do something on a bigger picture now. And the product also focuses on an experience.
Okay, Santosh, thanks a lot
thank you so
for
much.
Being with us, and all the best.
Thank you so much for having me.